All right, let's talk about we talk about this man. I mean, what do you make of Usain Bolt? Can he be a professional footballer?
I think Usain Bolt's ambition is bigger than his ability.
Okay. Wow.
I've seen him play.
You're not nice at all. You're not.
I've seen him play for Borussia Dortmund.
What is the A-League? He's the A-League, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
You can just cut it.
Well, I really do not know if he'll make it as a professional footballer, in truth, at whatever levels. I think that his abilities are quite limited. I've seen him play. He's got pace, but, you know, he wants to play as an outfield player. If he was a defender, he probably would have been
a
goalkeeper or something. But he wants to use that pace to run past people. It requires some footballing technique. You just don't run and run into people. So he can train. He can, again, you know, age is not on the side. This is football we're talking about. He's trying to start out at a time when people are retiring. You know, so I mean, I wish that for whatever he's worth, for the sheer spectacle of watching the world's greatest sprinter play football, you know, it'd be nice to see. And then the draw that it is for the league that, you know, he's going to be playing in. It's a media, you know,
circus.
Yeah, exactly. It's not so much for the substance of the football that he's going to play. Usain Bolt is not going to excite anyone, you know, really playing football. But because of who he is, you know, every time he gets on the pitch, there's a lot of attention around it. We're hoping that it does something, you know, even if it's a deflected, you know, shot, something cannons off him and enters the net and is credited with a goal. We hope that something just happens that can make the headlines for the right reasons. Or that can mean that he makes the headlines for the right reasons. But I commend his passion. If there's anything that I really, really admire about him, it's that he's willing to start from the scratch. Yeah. Not a lot of people who've hit the heights in whatever area of life want to, you know,
start
from the bottom, really. That's commendable. And it's a lesson that a lot of us must learn from life. You know, you don't transfer, especially football, for instance, where people think that because they were successful footballers, they should just naturally translate to becoming successful managers, coaches, and starting at the top level. No, you have to, you know, learn to press restart, which is what the Lampards of this world, Gerrards of this world, maybe Gerrard, you know, people argue Rangers is a big Scottish club, you know, but Usain Bolt is showing to us that you don't transfer proficiency at the highest level in one human endeavor into another just like that. It doesn't work that way. You've got to learn to start from the bottom, and sometimes it can take, you know, trying in multiple places and being rejected like it's been for Usain Bolt.
So a few months down the line, if the guy surprises you, and we bring you back here, you give him an apology for saying he's not going to cut it.
And I have a very, you know, special ability, if I have to say that myself, for sporting talent.
So he's not one.
So I know when a guy can play football. You know, I've seen his touches, I've seen his moves.
Right.
You know, he can't even keep his head up when he's running with the ball. Those are fundamental, you know, challenges with football. You don't learn that at 30-something year old.
Just keep that in mind. If he surprises you, we'll come back to apologize.
Quickly, we'll look at the papers before we call it a day here. Okay,
Yemi, Complete
Sports.
All right, Complete Sports. Gerald Ross saying Moses is too young to retire. That's the Tuesday edition of Complete Sports. We're pressed for time, but Bada, quickly, Moses, we all agree he's too young to retire.
Yeah, to retire from the national team at 27, you know, I think tells me that he probably feels like he's been dead on that. He's achieved everything he set for himself from national
two World Cups,
one AFCON in 2013. What's more to achieve? But I also
just 37 appearances.
Yeah, I also have never seen Victor Moses as someone who's ever really, really prioritized representing the national team. So
fair point.
It's you know,
but it's going to be a big blow, though.
Yeah, for him, you know, a distraction that's been taken out of the way. Now he can focus on his club football. And I think that he would need that focus because Antonio Conte backed him. Yeah. I don't think Sarri has a liking for his game. He has to prove himself all over again. So maybe he's just trying to get his head down and focus on his club football and get himself back to he's supposed to be.
Okay, sports and life here. Of course, the FIFA ban that will work with Pinnick and others. That's coming from FIFA. And also no plans to beg Victor Moses, and that's what NFF is saying. As you said, it says they've already had that, so... LFF understood that, so they will respect his decision. But I'm going to miss him anyway, and I love his run and everything. Mourinho will be gone before Christmas. But then there's a story that came out this morning, late last night, that the club's actually backing him.
So when you are backed, that's trouble.
Yeah, that's a proverbial case of death.
Okay.
When there's a vote of confidence being expressed by the board, usually it is followed shortly by the sack.
Okay.
And if results don't improve significantly for Manchester United, Mourinho might actually be gone before we say Merry Christmas.
Okay, we'll see if it's going
to
happen.
But thank you today, Johnson. It's been nice having you with us. Unfortunately, we run out of time. But
thank you so much.
I really do appreciate you coming. Hopefully, we'll do this again soon.
Always a pleasure. Yeah, soon.
Public holiday.
Okay. All right. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of your day. Do enjoy the holidays. But we'll be back here tomorrow. Till then, John Oshkin, I'm Jamie Adebayo.
And I'm Cicely Amorim. Thanks for watching.